Hey streamers, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be running you through how you can broadcast a live event such as a concert, music festival, maybe even a conference. But not only that, I'll also be showing you how you can create a page where you will insert the player shortcode from WP Stream so that you can live stream wherever you want on your website. So the first thing you'll want to do is add a page, so create a new page and name this page. So I'm naming it live stream, for example. And after I've done that, I'm just going to publish it. And we'll have that over there on standby. So let's go to view page. And once we've created the page, we'll want to add this page to this menu over here. So between home and cart, for example. So I'm just gonna go back and now I will go to appearance and then to menus. And here's where I do all the editing and I can shift where I want each page to be. So I'm just going to find the live stream page that I just created. And here it is, it's actually the first one. Didn't see it the first time. So I'm just going to add that to menu. And as you can see, it appeared right at the bottom. So I'm just going to shift that to the top and you can move all the other ones as well, but I'm happy with the current arrangement. So I'll just save my menu. Now that I have changed my menu, let's go and check it out. And here it is, live stream. It's right between home and cart, and it's just going to be easily accessible to anyone who comes to your website. Now let's go back and get started with the plugins you need. So go to plugins and make sure that you install and activate WP Stream. And that's what we're using for video streaming on WordPress. And you'll also want WooCommerce because we're going to create a pay-per-view channel. And a pay-per-view channel is basically a live stream that your viewers will purchase before they can actually watch. Once we've done that, let's go to WP Stream Credentials, and here you will either sign in if you already have an account on WP Stream, or you will create a new one by registering. So of course, you'll want to enter all your details and register. Now here you are on the WP Stream dashboard where you will also find your free trial package and you can confirm your email address to receive an extra 5 GB of streaming data. So don't forget to do that. Once we've done that, I'm going back and connecting with my account that I just created. So as you can see, I'm connected and now we can go ahead and create a new channel. So go to channels under WP Stream. And you can either create a free channel or a pay-per-view channel, depending on what your event will be. And I'm creating a pay-per-view channel for this particular video because I want to show you how you can basically sell tickets to an event. So just click on pay-per-view channel and here you will, of course, give the product a name, the live stream a name. You can write any descriptions, make sure it's a live channel under product data, and assign a price. I'm just currently giving it $8.99. You can also add it as a sale if you wish. You can add any featured or product images, tags, categories, and once you are happy with your results and how your product looks like, you will then have to publish the channel. So click publish, and yeah. Here it is how it's going to look like. And as you can see, right next to the name of the live stream, there's a number. So that's the channel ID 786. And you will want to add that number to the short code of the WP Stream player. So let's go back to the page we created and we will want to edit this page. And I'm editing with Elementor, but it also works with WP Bakery or with just regular short codes. So just click on the plus and here you will want to add a widget. So look up WP Stream Player. And here are the different options, but we'll want to drag the WP Stream Player right over here. And once we have done that, you'll see that this product slash free product ID will show up. And this is where you will add that channel ID. or the product ID in this case. So go back to channels and just copy paste this number, copy the 786, go back and paste it right in this section. And once you've pasted this, it has been connected to this page, so the live stream page that we created at the beginning of this video. Update the page and you're ready to start your live event. You can check out the settings and just see if you would like to record your live stream, if you want to display viewer count, locked website, autoplay, etc. So just read all of these settings and see what you like, and then you can start your live event. So while we wait, let's talk about OBS Studio, which is a free pro tool that you can use to broadcast live events. You'll go to Settings, Stream, and you will need to add a server and stream key that is released by WP Stream once you click on Go Live with External Broadcaster. So copy this server and stream key and paste into the appropriate section and then OK. Now you're ready, you can start streaming. Go back and you can either click on View Channel if you want or go directly to the page. But as you can see, before I can actually watch it, I have to purchase the video. So I'll just add to cart and complete the checkout process. And once that's done, I will click on this link over here and it will take me to my broadcast. So here it is. I'm currently live and the display viewer is right on the top. If I click on the live stream page where I created, which I created, here is a video. You can enjoy it like this. You can go full screen as well if you wish to and enjoy the full experience. You could also go picture in picture and move this screen. It becomes a tiny screen and you can move it around the page and you can shift through different tabs as well and still watch the live stream. And yeah, that's how you can broadcast a live event, a pay-per-view live event to be specific. And once you're done, go back to OBS Studio and click on Stop Streaming. Once you've stopped streaming, you will see that the live stream would have ended and this message will appear. And that's how you know your broadcast is over. You can also edit this text if you wish to, just check out the link down description bar. And now, remember I recorded the live stream, so I'm just gonna go back and recover it by going to WP Stream Media Management. And from here, you can either create a free video on demand or a pay-per-view video on demand. I want to create a pay-per-view video on demand once again. I want to sell this VOD to others and make sure it's a video on demand, of course, under product data. I'm just going to assign it a smaller price than the live, of course. I will set a product image, any tags, categories, any description that you want. And then once you're happy, you'll follow the same steps as with the live stream, creating the live stream, and you will publish this product, this VOD product. I'll click on the link and again, I will need to purchase before I can watch this video on demand. So I will complete the checkout process once again and click on this link over here. And here's my VOD. So with a live stream, you can't skip forward, go back, of course, but with a VOD, you can indeed, you can stop, play, skip forward, go back. And just like with the live stream, you can also go full screen or picture in picture. So yeah, I can move this around the screen once again and switch through different tabs. And that is how you create a pay-per-view video on demand from a live stream on WordPress. And in this video, I also showed you how you can create a live stream of an event, sell tickets, and also include via a shortcode or a widget, a block on a specific page on your WordPress website. I hope that you've enjoyed this video and make sure you come back next week as we will be posting another one. Bye.